dark energy was what attracted Omar, an investigator from Spring Hill, Florida, to the now abandoned prison one night during the summer of 2017.
Hi, my name's Omar, and I filmed the video. There's just so many buildings to explore here. So much history.
You gotta have it so you can play some games on the TV. Make things go faster.
And then that?
Yeah.
We'll split up. So we kind of hung out a little bit at first. One way. I went the other way. But yeah, there's no cell phone reception out here. We are on our own as of now.
Never split up. That's rule number one. Do not split up. Doesn't anyone watch horror movies anymore? Always stay with your friend.
James? I'll give you a little glimpse here. There it is right there.
Perhaps Omar wished James had stayed with him by the time he ventured into the prison's cafeteria.
This is the cafeteria straight of it. There's been so many stories tied to that cafeteria. I wanted to go in there and see if I would catch bumped into him. I wasn't hearing anything. I get ready to leave, and I hear it sounded like something moving behind me. I turn around and of course, it sounded like some metal, and I see this chair right in front of me move. What the f*** was that?
In the cafeteria, everyone is close together, they're eating their food, they're going about their daily routines, and this is going to leave an imprint over time. Just the same routine, the same actions over and over and over. And again, this is a prison, so if something like a fight or a riot broke out, that would intensify the chances for haunting.
I get a little closer to investigate, and I ask it to move again. Move this chair again. Nothing's happening, so of course I get ready to walk away.
I think that's too big.
I ran out of there so quick.
When chairs start moving around on their own, you're obviously gonna get a little freaked out.
There were no strings attached to the chairs that were moving around. I mean, that was kind of obvious because they were moving in all different directions. And nobody else was around him. I mean, you know, these prisons weren't built for a resort. They were built for punishment.
Buildings like this that house hatred and stressful environments, like, it creates this, like, flourish that it needs to feed off of fear and hatred in order for those energies to keep manifesting. So when you have a lot of negative haunts like that, buildings become hungry for more negativity. You don't want to be in a place that feeds off of negativity, and prisons tend to be those types of places.
Surprise of the night.
There's so many haunted stories tied to the Brushy prison. One that caught me by surprise was of the Magnificent Seven, which was the gang. Supposedly this gang took four guards hostage, and they ended up shooting about, I want to say, like seven or eight African Americans, two of which who died. Now if you go inside of this prison cell block, the very first two, the ones that died, they're both, their names are James. One of the stories that people say is that if you leave a cigarette, because James, the second prison inmate that was killed, shot and killed by the Magnificent Seven, you can actually see and witness a cigarette being smoked. Now, I try to put this to the test.
James, go ahead and take a giant puff and let me know that you're here with me.
Myself at home, and it didn't work. I put the cigarette down, and I thought if I turned the lights off, I'd get a blow on the hand, and it would light up, but it didn't. Clearly this one, you could see it actually getting sucked in, not just like, you know, blowing all over the place.
Immediately after it happened, he clicked his light on so we can verify that there was no one in the cell. There was no one around the cigarettes. It just... It's almost unexplainable.
I've heard many reports of cigarette smoke being smelled in a place where, you know, no one is smoking and no one's even been for months, days, even years. So there's something about tobacco in the paranormal. There's some sort of connection there.
Omar was using that cigarette as a trigger object for something that hopefully the spirit would be interested in. If you were doing an investigation in one of the ancient records of toys in a prison or a cigarette. And I know people that have gone on investigations where, you know, the former owner of a home or a location was a smoker and they lay some cigarettes around to see, you know, what might happen.
I wasn't expecting anything at all to happen. I thought maybe it was just, had it been just from it, just a gust of wind coming through. I'm not a smoker, so I don't really know, but I've had smokers tell me that in fact was somebody puffing on a cigarette. It scared me so much that as soon as, I mean, it was like instant, I turned my light on and didn't see there was nobody there.
The one common thing that I find about every prison, jail, and penitentiary is that it housed violent people. It has a history of fear and despair and hopelessness. And these things echo through time.
It's just the perfect melting pot of tragedy and trauma, and that just sticks to the walls like glue.
Brushy Mountain has to be one of those places where it was just truly unique to me in so many different ways. I mean, it was, to me, hands down, probably the scariest place I've ever been.